The Blasius family is full of multi-sport athletes.
I try to incorporate wrestling, rodeo, and football into my everyday activities.
You know, a good wrestler makes a good football player, which makes a good tie-down roper. You know, they all kind of connect in the same way.
And they've taken their talents to numerous state championships over the years.
And the champion in Class B at 170 pounds from Philip area, Burke Blasius.
Three-time winner we have here. A state championship last 3 years. Congratulations to him.
In Class B at 138 pounds from Philip area, Jace Blasius. In third place at 152 pounds, Blair Blasius.
In 2022, brothers Burke, Blair, and Jace helped lead the Wall Eagles to a state title at the Dakota Dome.
You don't get very many opportunities to play on that big of a stage, and especially to come home with a championship. You don't see very often, so I'm pretty proud that I did that. I've start quarterback for the Wall team, and so wrestling and football combined, I think are pretty big accomplishments.
I kicked for my football team, and I'd say I'm an above average kicker. I'd say I'm all right at it.
From the hash mark, it's high enough. Swung him up. It's good. From 40.
For wrestling, I've achieved what I set out to do. And same thing for football. We just won a state championship. So rodeo is kind of the last sport I'm trying to get that state championship in.
As the sports seasons change, the brothers modified their schedules to make the most of their training.
I wake up at 5:30-ish, I'd say, probably every morning. I run out and do some chores.
And you're roping the bale and roping the horns.
And I go to the weight room, plyometric, stuff like that.
And then you go to school for the day, come home at night.
Do chores, rope, or football, wrestle, you know, whatever that looks like, whatever sport I'm in currently at the time.
And right when you get home, you're saddling your horse and getting ready to either tie down rope or team rope or both.
If I have a little spare time, I'll throw the ball with my brothers, or I'll go down and wrestle with my brothers. And just try to focus mainly on whatever sport it is, and then the other two sports come after that.
Oh, yeah, Ricky.
Since the beginning, their oldest brother, Lane, has been a mentor. And he still shows up to support them on competition day.
Growing up here in the same place, at the same school, doing the same sports, I can help them as they progressed. And so, yeah, it started when they were little. We have a wrestling mat in our basement, and I don't think I could count the amount of wrestling sessions we've had down there, and it goes. The same thing goes for the arena out here, and you know, there's lots of footballs up there, and we throw the football all the time. It started, you know, more than 10 years ago, so we've been working on critiquing things and getting better and having a good mindset, being faithful, and just everything, you know.
Our faith is strong. We're Catholics, and we're proud of that, and it's our foundation, and so. You know, it's behind everything we do.
I have a famous saying that I always do when they're pretty nervous. I say three Hail Marys. The first one, you won't understand what you're doing. The second one, you'll realize you're saying a prayer. And the third one will mean something. That's the key to everything.
Faith is the priority in my life. Mentally, you know, I gotta be mentally strong, but where I get that from is my faith in Christ. You know, I rely on him a lot. When something's going wrong, I ask him for help, and it seems to work out in the end, even if something's not going right in the moment.
When you're back in the box, one thing I like to do is you just kind of like to think about what you have to do in steps. I try to calm myself down mostly and maybe say a prayer or two, I guess, for good measure. I always say a couple prayers to stay safe, and then I try to keep my nerves as low as possible. Sometimes my nerves get a little the best of me, but I try to deal with them as best as I can.
We try really hard at everything we do, and I've always put, you know, some pressure on the boys to do their best, or we have. And yet, at the end of the day, it's just a sport.
Obviously, since they were little, they know that their grades come first, and so I don't ever have to check on them because they check on themselves, and they've been pretty successful.
In the arena, their horses are their teammates, and they share a special bond.
The one I'm riding right now, his name's Cool Hand Luke. My other one, Cat Daddy. Both of them, I'd say, are really good at what they do. The more you ride with the horse, you know, the better you feel you have for him. And it's always great, you know, the better horse, you know, the better you're gonna be often.
His name is Freckles. What's kind of special about Freckles is we race him here. We've had him since the beginning. he was out of one of our mares and our firewater jet stud. And so that's kind of cool. We've got to have him around a long time. And I started heading on him, and I like him a lot. He's like my best friend, basically, in the arena. You know, I put a lot of trust in him, and he trusts me. Every time I rope, he never misses a day. When we go back to the barn and we unsaddle, he's always looking for a scratch. And if you're not paying attention at the moment, he might knock you over because he kind of busts into you. But that's one thing that's cool about Freckles is we just have such a good relationship, and we trust each other in the arena and in the pen. And so that's really cool. I love him. His name is Logan Storley. I named him after a wrestler. He came from Webster. His name's Logan Storley. He was a NCAA All-American for about 4 years for the University of Minnesota, and he's a sorrel, so I named him Logan Storley. He's getting on the upper side of his age, so I gotta take care of him more. Every night I grain him, and me and him kind of have a pretty good bond. We know each other kind of inside out, and I know what I have to do with him to get what I need to do in each rodeo, and he's been working pretty good for me these last couple years.
When they're not in the arena, on the mat, or on the football field, the brothers from Wall have a variety of hobbies.
I'm a wrestling shoe trader and collector. I have a collection of shoes that not many people know about, and they're in my room where my brothers can't get them, and they're pretty valuable to me, so I buy and sell shoes like that.
I'd also say I'm a pretty good cook. My specialty is guacamole, so I'm pretty good at that.
I play some video games, sometimes probably more than I should. Golf and hanging out with friends are kind of my top three things I like to do on my free time.
To top it off, Burke is adding barber to his growing list of titles, giving his friends a fresh cut when they need it. Despite a packed schedule, the Blasius family always finds time for what's most important to them.
No matter what sport it's in, no matter what time of the year it is, we've never missed Mass on Sunday. I've never missed it, not once.
Everything we have and everything that we've earned is something that we believe God gave us, and so applying that faith mentality to everything we do is super important. And
I wouldn't trade it for anything, even though it's stressful at times. It's a lot of fun, and I know I'll look back on it and smile, so I like it.